Namespaces are used to avoid naming conflicts by allowing us to group entities, such as classes and functions, under a separate scope. In this example, we have two classes that belong to the global scope. Because they both share the same name and scope, this code will not compile. One way to solve this problem would be to rename one of the conflicting classes. Another solution is to group one or both of them under a different namespace by enclosing each in the namespace block. The classes now belong to different scopes, and so there is no longer a naming conflict. To access a member of a namespace from outside of that namespace, we need to specify the member's fully qualified name. This means that we have to prefix the member name with the namespace it belongs to, followed by the scope resolution operator. To further structure the program entities, it's possible to nest namespaces any number of levels deep. We just need to be sure that we qualify the nested namespace members with a full namespace hierarchy. If we don't want to have to specify the namespace every time we use one of its members, we can import the namespace into the global or local scope with the help of a using declaration. This declaration includes the using namespace keywords, followed by the namespace to be imported. It can be placed either locally, where it will only have effect until the end of the code block, or it can be placed in the global scope, where it will affect the code in the source file that follows its declaration. Keep in mind that importing a namespace into the global scope defeats the main purpose of using namespaces, which is to avoid naming conflicts. Such conflicts, however, are mainly an issue in projects that use several independently developed code libraries. If we don't want to have to type the fully qualified name, but also don't want to import the whole namespace, we can instead import only the specific members that we need from the namespace. This is done one member at a time with a using keyword, followed by the fully qualified namespace member that we want to import. Another thing we can do to shorten the fully qualified name is to create a namespace alias. The namespace keyword is then used, followed by an alias name to which we assign the fully qualified namespace. This alias can then be used instead of the namespace qualifier that it represents. Note that both the namespace member imports and the namespace aliases may be declared both globally and locally. Finally, remember that in C++, merely importing a namespace does not provide access to the members included in that namespace, unless they are defined in the current source file. In order to access the namespace members, the prototypes also have to be made available, for example, using the appropriate include directives.